200 people there. It was packed, but 200 people was all to get in there. And we sing about 45 minutes. And we sing the gospel. So I always try to give people, you know, an opportunity to respond to the gospel. And so we sing about 45 minutes, and I'm Baptist, so we had everybody to bow their heads and close their eyes, because it's what Baptist folks do. And so I said, listen, is there anybody here tonight that you're unsure, you know, if you've ever really surrendered your life to the Lord? And out of that 200 people, one sweet little teenage girl, the second row up from the back, slipped her little hand up and put it right back down. And so I told the congregation, of course I didn't know who it was because they had their heads bowed and their eyes closed, but I told them, I said, listen, we need to pray for somebody here tonight. And so we did, we prayed for that sweet girl, and then we sang the next song that we're getting ready to sing for you. Now we didn't know it until after the concert was over. Listen, we didn't know it until after it was over, but after it was over, she was in the back. She had a bunch of her little friends back there with her. She had the pastor back there with her. She was crying. She wanted to call us back there and just tell us that during the song, she surrendered her life to the Lord. Huge deal, man. Whether it's dozens or whether it's one, we're just happy to be a small part of whatever God's doing. It was awesome. Here's her story. 16 years old, never knew who her daddy was. Her mom had been a drug addict all of her life. She had two older brothers. Both of them were drug addicts. And so during the song, she had a conversation with the Lord. She said, Lord, I don't want to live that kind of life for myself. I want to live a life for you. Will you save me? Guess what he said? He said, yeah. He said, yes. He saved her right back there in the pew. She didn't have to shake the pastor's hand. She didn't have to fill out a card. She just did business with the Lord right back there on the pew. He saved her. She lived in a children's home, and I'm thankful for the mom of the children's home that brought her there that night so she could hear the gospel. Now, here we are tonight. I'm looking out through here, man. I know a lot of you guys, most of you I know, probably in church, you go to church somewhere, and you guys don't have any problems. It's a spiritual bunch. I can just tell by looking at you. You got up this morning, you ate breakfast, and then you fasted all the way up until lunch. So I know what I'm dealing with here tonight. I can feel it. But maybe you know somebody with some problems. Maybe it's a son. Or maybe it's a grandson. Or maybe it's a daughter. Or maybe it's one of those sweet little granddaughters. Maybe it's a husband or a wife. And you know that they're dealing with something that's just bigger than they are and that has them strapped and has them bound. Listen. Maybe it's you tonight. And you're here and yeah, you like Southern gospel music, or maybe you were drugged here by a friend. I don't know. But you know, you know that you're dealing with things tonight. You have strongholds in your life, and you know that you're powerless against it. And you know that you're chained, and you need God to show up and show out in your life. Can I just suggest that you do business with the Lord, maybe right where you're sitting, just like that sweet young girl did back there? You know, the Bible says in Romans 10:13 that whosoever shall call upon his name can be saved. You can be saved right where you're sitting tonight. Just surrender your life to Christ. I want you to consider that as Scotty comes and sings this song. I want you to listen to the words. They simply say this. If you've got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you've got chains, he's a chain breaker. And I pray this tonight, if you've got chains, that you will allow the Lord to break those chains, even right where you're sitting tonight.